Avengers Endgame is officially the biggest movie to hit the box office, and it has rather large reported production budget as well. A good chunk of that, of course, goes to the stunning visual effects needed to make such a grand blockbuster fit for the silver screen. As a result, there is a fair share of motion capture and motion reference actors involved in the making of the film that are never seen in the final product. One of those on the set of Avengers Endgame working as a motion reference actor was Guardians of the Galaxy star Sean Gunn, the brother of fan-favorite filmmaker James Gunn. Sean plays Craiglin in Guardians franchise while serving as a stand-in for Rocket in every appearance, including on the set of Avengers Infinity War and Avengers Endgame. You see, the thing that differentiates between motion capture and motion reference is the latter isn't required to wear this grey and black pajama type suit we have seen plenty times before. Rather, the actors are simply in play to give animators something to base the computer-generated character off. Unfortunately for Sean Gunn, that means he had to act disgusted as his head was hewed straight into Bro Thor's gut and groin area in New Asgard.
Give me a cuddly little rascal!
No, I'm good.
As evidenced in the below behind the scenes pics that have surfaced on Reddit, he was sure to point out the difference between capture and reference actors and how the effect vendors implement it all with the latest technology. The thing that was unusual is that the motion capture part of it, which is technically motion reference, not motion capture because it's not, they're not doing it through a computer gun reflected. The animators are literally watching what I do and animating that rather than sending it through an algorithm the way that you would do it with the way you would do it a more humanoid character. That doesn't work for a raccoon. It just doesn't, the technology isn't there. It doesn't look good enough. So the animators actually watch what I do and animate that. What Phase 4 Marvel film are you looking forward to most? Share your thoughts in the comments below. Have you subscribed to Box Office yet? If you haven't, then go ahead and subscribe our channel and check out our latest work.